How are we expressing, how are we expressing love for each other, though? Because
I think the key to any relationship is intimacy. I think if you don't have that intimacy, you can't, there's nothing to build on.
Yeah.
You know what just come to mind? Don't lose your point. Is where is the mama tune, the mama tune, the men cry too.
Yeah, you know?
At the same time, me hear a woman say the worst thing they can't see is I'm on a ball. They can't take it.
No. Organize, sit down, reason, and talk.
While there are ongoing tensions in South Sudan and in Ethiopia, and the conflict between Russia and the Ukraine has been successful in removing COVID from the dialogue in mainstream media, or so-called mainstream media, we here at ORT discuss black intimacy. What is it, and are we getting enough? This week's ORT.
Greetings, Kush.
How are you doing?
I'm good, you know, I'm good.
Okay, well, one second. I'm just gonna get some water, which I should have got, and I forgot to get it. 1 second.
Greetings, Kindred. How are you?
Greetings, Ebony. I'm good. How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
And greetings to Brother S, who I'm sure is probably listening in.
Ah, indeed. You're very much missed, Brother S. Thank you.
Indeed.
Dulcet tones, you know.
In it.
Oh, absolutely.
Well, the whole land can put on a vice in a one blender, you know, and blend it up and see if what you come out with is anywhere near, brother.
I can't imagine it would even come close.
No, it's only one brother.
Not even.
Okay. Okay. Well.
And if we did, I'd be quite worried, wouldn't you, Kindred?
In it, though.
Yes, well.
Some hormonal imbalance is there somewhere.
Yes.
Tell me.
Indeed, man. So, how are you keeping, Kindred?
I'm but busy, as I'm sure you can well imagine. But, you know, but overall, just trying to keep things on an even keel. I'm good. I can't complain. And I won't.
Okay. Well, a kwaba to another ORT. Show of love and light, you know, and we have two of our resident panelists. We have Queen Ebony Harmony, our voice of compassion.
Greetings, listeners. I hope you are all well.
And we also have our Queen of Analysis, Kindred Spirit.
Greetings, everybody, and positive vibes to you all.
And I'm Baba Kosh. And today we are discussing black intimacy and whether or not we are getting enough, basically. Do we think we are getting enough black intimacy as opposed to romance? So black intimacy as opposed to romance. But before that, we're going to talk about what's been catching our eye. Has anything caught any of the Queen's eye since the last time we spoke to it?
Well, there is something that's been catching my eye over the last two or three weeks. And it's a couple of stories that's to do with university, as a matter of fact. The first was, I don't know if you saw it, there was a report about 2 or 3 weeks ago, just raising concern that many of these universities are profiteering off students and sort of looking into that a bit more deeply. And then I think it was last week, the announcement of what they're calling the whole cost of living crisis and, you know, the impact that that's going to have on tuition fees. And it just makes me, it makes me wonder whether or not we might need to be having a different conversation with some of our young people about universities, you know, because I don't know. We all value education, and that, you know, that goes without saying. But there's more than one type of education, and there's more than one route into education. And it just reminded me, I think it was a long time ago, I think it was somebody, if it wasn't Gus John, it was somebody of that caliber. round about the time when Tony Blair's government was really promoting university for all. And I think it was Gus John who made the point that most black people get their degrees as mature students.
Yeah.
They come into university in the sort of their 30s or 40s, having done other things, or it's an indirect route.
Yeah.
And it just made me think about that.
Yeah.
That maybe this going in at 18, accumulating all of this debt.
Yeah, man.
I just wonder, for a degree that may not turn out to be an investment.
Well,
I just wonder if maybe we need to be looking at that a bit more closely. Like,
indeed. And one of the things we have to understand is that Britain was a manufacturing country.
Exactly, yeah.
They don't manufacture anything anymore.
Mm-hmm.
But they do have other industries that offer people employment, and education is one of those industries.
Yeah.
So,
definitely.
You know, you must see it as your enrollment within it. Yes, it's empowering to get a degree or to be around learning is the thing for me. It's not so much whether you get the degree, it's to be around learning. That's the most important thing. But at the same time, we must also see, we're just being part of the food chain. And like what you quite rightly said, you end up coming out with all this debt. So, you know, we have to look at education in its most broadest terms.
Definitely.
Yes, that's a very, very, very good one. Hey, Bunny. Harmony, what's been catching your eye? Not that you only have one, you know. I don't want nobody to think you only have one eye. Two very nice eyes.
Not that there's anything wrong with somebody with one eye.
Nothing wrong with it. But I'm just saying, you don't have one eye. That's why we are clarifying.
Thank you for clarifying.
Okay, good. Okay, all right.
Okay, well, nothing's caught my eye, but that was it's quite deliberate. However, I didn't realise how deliberate it was until I was trying to research the thing that catch my eye to talk about today. And in fact, I decided to look inwards and look into myself and see what caught my eye for myself, you know, internalizing self-love and just reasoning with myself. And I was thinking, how often do we do that as individuals? Well, perhaps that's where I need to focus for this week, and, you know, maybe put it out there and consider and ask us all to consider. How much do we look in?
Yes,
very important point, Ebony. Very important point.
Yeah, man. Brother S is not here, you know. So this apology I'm gonna have to give him is gonna be easier to do because he's not present. I owe him an apology in regards the. What he said about Rockwell, that's right. He said Rockwell was the recorder of the song. And I said, no, it's not, it's Michael Jackson. Because I've never heard of Rockwell. I've never even heard his part of the song. I just sit here, I just know the punchline. People knew the punchline. So I have to apologize to him. So, and then somebody wrote on social media that Michael Jackson denied his involvement in the song for years. As a way of basically helping Rockwell's career. So that's something that he's not here, so I can apologize. If he wasn't here, it'd be more difficult.
So there was a Michael Jackson connection though.
Yeah. Yes, definitely. Journey Within. Very good point there from Ebony. And I was thinking, never caught my eye, really, even though so many things are going on that we can't comment on. But I was wondering if we would ever think it necessary to give the Dutch pot some kind of royal treatment as black people. You know, like you just have some objects which, you know, become for certain cultures, they become, you know, you can't mess with this, you know, it's like a listed building. And I'm saying, will we ever get to the point where we're going to give this pot its honors for what it's done for us? Are we going to give it some royal seal or something? Where so if anybody else using it, you're messing with our culture. Like, oh, you'd go buy a wok, and you know, so I just Chinese people use a wok. You know, will we ever get to that point when we give it? It's real and proper status, guys. That Batman, let me tell you.
It needs some kind of protected. Well, maybe we need to patent it or something. You know.
That may I say. So yes, we have our top topic to discuss later on about black intimacy. But before that, we have our quiz. And I know I'm with some of the sharpest minds when it comes down to matters related to melanated people. People, are you ready? No! Oh, Lord. So, question one. How would you describe eating tripe? If you had to tell someone who would never taste it. That's one description.
Like eating wet carpet, perhaps?
Yeah. Yeah. I would say even that was very generous.
Okay. I couldn't describe it. Somebody described it once to me, not in terms of eating it, but they said, "Oh, it looked like a blanket." And I thought that's one of the best descriptions I've heard of.
Well, it's a painful memory, Kush. It's a painful memory.
Yeah. Well, some people still like it, man. Some people still like it. I'm trying, but I mean, they love it. So, question two. When black people see a heinous crime on the news, what are their first thoughts? Don't tell me you don't think what I written down here.
Oh, you mean I hope it's not somebody black.
Exactly.
Okay, all right.
No, Anasa?
It's true.
Yeah.
Anasa? Yeah. Especially.
Sorry, I had to.
Listen, any rape or something like that, it's like, yo.
Yes, please, feel for the victim.
But guess what? We just feel for God.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Please, no, yeah.
Let's go searching for a picture.
You see me? Oh.
Oh.
What is it? This one really was for Brother S, you know. This one, he said, Brother, he said, pick the night, you know, not to be here, though. Brother, trust me, this one was for you. Because you said that there's little interest for black people in the Winter Olympics. So, I was going to test you on that. So, the question three is, what is the connection between skeletons and Brogan Crowley?
That one stumped me.
You see?
We have a clue.
Well,
Winter Olympics.
Winter Olympics, yes. I know what you're thinking. She's part of the Jamaican ice chewing team. No, she's not. No, she's doing something competitive.
Even though you could.
Is she the woman on the bobsleigh team?
Yes.
The driver.
Yes.
Oh yes, I saw her. Yes. Okay. She's the first one, isn't she?
Yes. So big up yourself, bro. Girl.
Yeah, that split myself. Yeah, that split me for a minute. And then I remember.
Yeah, man. So that question was put with Brother S in mind, as he said, black people. And I was surprised to see how much black people were up there.
We've got a skier as well, haven't we?
I'm not sure.
Yeah, we do.
Question four. Which three reggae legends are born in February?
Wow. Dennis Brown?
Yep, that's one.
I can't remember. Is Bob one? I don't remember. Bob?
Bob who?
Oh, Marley.
Oh, Bob Marley. Yes, yes. Yes. He definitely is
a personal friend of mine, you know. First name basis.
Yeah, you know, I have no doubt.
Yeah, we just didn't.
I have no doubt.
Didn't want to embarrass ourselves. Put it. And there's one more. This one, you're gonna know it, but you probably didn't know. You will know the hardest. And thinking about one of their big tunes, he was in a band. And they had a big tune, and it's one of them songs. Thinking about today's topic about intimacy, it's one of those kind of brotherly love songs type songs, a very big song. And the title of it was "Now That We Found Love." You're close to it. Okay, so it's Third World and it's Bonnie Rugs. Bonnie Rugs.
Thank you, Third World. Rugs.
I'm thinking Jacob Miller.
Yes, well, he was close to Jacob Miller. All right, so that was question four. Question five. Now, you got to think very carefully here because I don't want you to give away any symbols or chords. I just want you to confirm yay or nay. It is said that black people have a secret code of signaling to each other when they're at work, when they're talking about a black person. True or false? I don't want, if it's true, please, we don't want any form of secret society symbols and movements. We don't want you to describe anything. We're not interested.
Dear.
We just want to know, is it true that you know, black people, when talking about black people, have a thing that they do to say, you know what I'm saying?
It's true. I've seen it.
Okay. Okay. And Kendra?
Well, I would say the code is when they're talking about white people.
Okay. Right. Well, listen, mate, who says there has to be one?
We are multilingual when it comes to the code.
Yeah, when you're oppressed, you find all kinds of ways of communicating, which are unusual.
Communication. So I will say yes. I with Ebony on the yes, but I would also throw that in as well.
Okay, good. All right. So, which author is seen as the key reference point when talking about the Black Renaissance in Harlem, out of these three? Langston Hughes, Zora Neale Hurston, or Claude McKay?
Langston.
Okay.
You see, because Claude McKay come from Jamaica, you don't think he could be the man, eh? You see? I hope people are seeing what's happening right here now. The man who Winston Churchill took his speech from, it can't be him. Well, as it turns out, it actually is him.
Okay.
Claude McKay.
Well, I stand corrected. I always associate it with Langston Hughes, but I stand corrected.
I would have thought so too.
Yeah. So, question seven. I was born on the 12th of September 1944 in Galveston, Texas, United States. My name is Barry Eugene Carter. Who am I?
Any clues?
Oh,
hang on. What year?
1944.
Ooh.
Give me.
Want the clues?
So.
Orchestra.
Oh, I watched a documentary the other night. Barry White.
Yes, man!
We got it together, didn't we?
Yes, man, so fitting with our...
Nice guess, Ebony.
To say your guess.
Imagine. I watched a documentary about a week ago. While we
were in
Madeira.
We're talking about intimacy. Don't fight. Don't quarrel. Hush, hush, hush.
I can easily feel myself slipping more and more waves. And that super world of my own. Nobody but you and me. We've got it together, baby.
Why the main goal of colonization was to totally depopulate and involuntarily mix the entire African continent in order to repopulate it with other races. Well, I have a message for black people. So if you're not black, you can stay. But if you're black, I want you to listen and listen good. The reason why history repeats itself is because the world is cyclic and whatever goes around must come back around. There was a time that Africa ruled Europe for 800 years, and when I say ruled, I don't mean with guns and ammunition, but with knowledge, love, light, and black excellence. So now, I want you, black child, to know that we have cycled back to that time. A time when the kingdom of God belongs to the poor and the slaves, and mine is just to cut and raise. Yours is to step into your awareness of self. Yours is to go back within and get into union with your ancestors, your DNA. Get your ancestral membership back and remember all that you are. Because among you are the descendants of the likes of Mansa Musa, kings, queens. Among you are the DNA of the Talai, the tribe of the Lion of Judah. Among you are the inventors of the hieroglyphics. Among you are the architectures of the Great Pyramids, the incredible mathematics of the Ishango Bone. Among you are the DNA of the Moors, the teachers of all modern European technology. Among you are the DNA that mentored great European philosophers like Pythagoras. As a black person, the DNA of slavery and colonization is not the only DNA that you carry, and they know that. The ancient, great African civilization is still present and imprinted deep in your soul. They can burn all the books and ruin all the universities, but your DNA is present. Your memory is present. Your ancestral knowledge is present deep in your soul and is yours forever. All I want to say is that there was a time they wanted to wipe you all off or mix you all up so there was no one left to remember. There was a time that remembering who you are would have been a great crime, and so the ancestors had you forget to protect you. But I'm here to assure you that it is now safe to remember the African royalties among you. It is time for black people to experience the excellence of their own blackness. It is time to awaken the extreme talents and excellence that are deeply rooted within you. It is now safe to show the world who you are. Go within and remember. Join into one with your ancestors.
This is ORT.
ORT. This show is sponsored by Sunrise Organic Seamoss. Who say can drink sunshine?
The herb is the healing of the nation, brothers and sisters. Hey, this is your brother, twin brothers from the Royal Maroon Herbs, 48 Right Lane, Peckham. For your healing, brothers and sisters out there, we have a comprehensive list of herbs. You can find your sarsaparilla, you can find your sea moss, you can find your brother rock, you can find your moringa. So what's up, leaf, guinea and weed? So come to the Royal Maroon Herb Shop, 48 Right Lane, Peckham. The herbs is the healing of the nation, brothers and sisters.
Today's the day I give thanks. I am here.
This is Solomon from Black Child Promotions, one of the UK's best black book distributors. And we operate across London. Come check us out. You can also check us out on Instagram at Black Child Promotions and Facebook Black Child Space Promotion. Peace, family.
ORT, we do it because we love you.
Now back to the debate.
All right. For this part of the show, I wanted to imagine a young man, black man, on his bed, bawling out his eyes at a picture on the wall and being filmed by his mother while his brother is sitting next to him. And the picture on the wall is his father, who sadly killed himself. And the young man is now letting out his anger. And it seems something that had been bottled up inside of him for a long time. So this is what Kindred Spirit is talking about when she speaks next.
About the impact of certain music and a lot of the things in popular culture and on social media doesn't really give rise to conversations about connection and intimacy in the way that we're talking about now. It's almost as though relationships are a fashion accessory. They're not something that has to be, you know, cultivated and worked at, and you build connections. And that part of the language is gone. So people don't even know how to express it verbally anymore. Yeah. Everything that young brother was saying was real and coming from deep within him. This was not, there's nothing superficial about that. This was raw emotion that was coming out. And where is there the time and the space and the language to have a conversation with that kind of emotional, realness, to really get out what it is that people are really feeling? Yeah. We're not really encouraged to, are we?
Yeah, man. Yeah, and you know something, in our other profession, you know, in terms of working with families who come to the attention of children's services and stuff like that. You know, your intimacy or the lack of is always seems to be a common theme. You know, with most of the families that come, the black families that come to their attention. You know, and whether that is real or perceived, it just seems that part of the fabric of their kind of mental health, their psychological well-being. It's like they couldn't put it all together because that side of it wasn't there. So we say that really for people to think about, you know, well, what does help look like? Because at the same time, some of us are uninterested in counseling and things like that.
Yeah.
So.
How are we expressing love for each other though? Because
here's the thing though, I think before we even get to love, and I think the key to any relationship is intimacy. I think if you don't have that intimacy, there's nothing to build on. You know, I mean, because you can feel that can feel that you're in love, but if you don't have intimacy with somebody in its broader sense, like you can have conversations, you can you know, you can speak to with trust. You know, intimacy feeds respect, you know, so again, it's the root of that. I think if you don't have intimacy, you have an illusion of a relationship.
There isn't anything there.
It's a fantasy, isn't it, really? And I think intimacy needs to come naturally. And
some people like their fantasies, you know.
Well, it's not real, is it? Intimacy is real. When you take the time to speak to somebody, to listen to somebody, when you feel able to, share your, to be vulnerable,
your real
to
self.
Be vulnerable and not be afraid to be vulnerable because you can trust that person. You've had that intimacy.
A big
you know, so I think everything, personally, I feel everything's built on intimacy. And if you don't have that intimacy that comes naturally, because you can talk to people all day long and fill the space and fill the ear, and you may talk to one person more than the other, but you're more intimate with that other person.
So,
and that's the strength of any relationship, I feel.
You know, as you talk, and you're very right in what you're saying, but I'm thinking in accordance with what you said, I'm thinking like some people, like somebody get 25 years, and who, and the person who's on this side, who is not incarcerated, you know, they may experience a emotional intimacy where they feel like, say, well, you know something, them still satisfied with each other.
But that's exactly what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because you could be in a relationship with somebody and have no intimacy, but have an illusion of a relationship.
Yeah.
But have far more intimacy with somebody else, a friend, or you know, somebody who you have a different relationship with, and that's more of a relationship than the one you're in with somebody who you're not intimate with.
Yeah.
I think that's true. It's the quality of the connection,
100%.
And that it's not necessarily the relationship itself. Yeah. It's what it is that connects you, and that will be different things with different people. I think there's almost this. We are in romantic relationship terms, but in this era of hookup, aren't we? And there is this thing where you keep your guard up, where it's running counter to that. You don't cultivate the intimacy because that's seen as weak, or you're a sin, or you're, you know, to express love and care for the other person is somehow being flipped over to be some kind of weakness, because we're all tough now, aren't we? And that it's very, very, because that's the climate, you don't then get the language evolving to allow people to talk about it in a different way. We've got particularly the younger generation who haven't heard. I mean, and again, I come back to the music a bit, but the music that we were listening to growing up was very expressive.
Expressive. Like, and people, in what regard?
I mean, if you looked, I mean, we've talked about, say, Lovers Rock, for example, right? People wore their heart on their sleeve, right? Okay. And there was nothing wrong with expressing your heartfelt feelings for somebody, what they meant to you, what they brought to your life, and how, you know, the hole that would be left if they weren't there.
Yeah.
And all right, you know, and that, it's in musical terms and it's entertainment, but it was out there.
Yeah.
It was somebody saying these words, and not just Lovers, but, you know, a lot of the classic soul tunes and stuff, people are putting it out there that this is what you mean to me,
but,
you know,
you are
important, you know, our connection matters.
You know what just come to mind, don't lose your point, is the mama tune, the mama tune, the men cry too.
Yeah, you know?
At the same time, Me hear a woman say the worst thing they can't see is I'm on a ball. They can't take it.
That depends on the kind of woman, goodness.
Exactly, you have to cut through a lot of the nonsense. But there were other songs as well, like, you know, Try a Little Tenderness, and tunes like that as well. That did make it very, very clear that was important. That was an important part of how you are and how you be with somebody who is important to you.
Listen, ma'am,
and that it was important to share that.
A drummer tell me one time, you know, him find it difficult to say certain things to his wife. But him say if he could, him just put it in her music, him just put it in songs, him write songs, that's what him do, and him feel like him can express himself more to his wife.
Does she know it's for her though?
I never got that far.
That's the thing.
I gotta do my own work.
There's
and I
no
really
point
go
if
for
she doesn't know.
I forgot.
Isn't that a thing that wasn't it you, Ebony, when we did the ORT chat a little while back, where we were looking at the tune?
Yeah.
And wasn't it you, Ebony, who gave us that amazing example of the brother who wrote the song for his wife.
Had his wife in the video. Absolutely.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I think, you know, there's nothing, and you know, we've had classic poets and people, there are many ways to do it, but it is the doing of it and the energy that creates.
And the intention. And, you know?
And the intention, exactly, yeah, well said. It's that.
In terms of a romantic context, you know, and that means that everybody excluded but the couple. So that's the difference between intimacy and romance in my eyes.
Can you say that again for me?
So romance is just a couple. You understand? They don't have no cultural obligations, no kind of obligations to a community, nothing of that nature. It's just a couple. Romeo and Juliet. They don't come from anywhere. Whereas intimacy is more broader. It's looking at, you know, father-son relationship, mother-daughter relationship, your relationships, generally speaking, you know?
There is something about, I mean, just thinking of the example, the recent example of Regina King and you know, the loss of her son. And there was, you know, he made an amazing tribute to his mum. That really was, you know, a beautiful, heartfelt tribute to his mum.
Yeah.
And if I just think of another example, the King Richard film about Venus and Serena's they had a lot of input into, and they acted as consultants. And what they said very clearly was they wanted to be involved in this because they wanted it to be a love letter to their dad. That's what they said. They wanted it to be their tribute. They didn't want anyone else telling the story and spinning it. They didn't want anybody spinning it in a way that was, you know, that was not a fair reflection of their dad. It's that kind of, and they put that out there. That's the words they used. It was a love letter to their father.
Which,
you know, what a beautiful sentiment. It's that. Yeah. And people being unashamedly, able to say these things. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
100%.
Yeah. Yeah. So.
And that's the intimacy. Unashamedly. Yeah. Willing and able to just say.
Yeah. Mm. You're going to have to excuse me 2 minutes because I'm going to kill this dog. I'm going to kill him. No, today.
Don't kick the dog. Don't kick it.
Not a cat.
Damn dog.
look like you come off second best, push.
Huh?
Look like you come off second best.
I just threw me out with £250,000 like Kurt Zuma.
Well,
I said, I give some leak. That pussy get half light. Compared to the beat when we have film.
There you go.
Once we save up that £250,000, I'm going
to tell you. Lick. That's where you're going wrong.
Yep. You see, and even that, you know, going back to intimacy and the animals and, you know, because I think it was the other day I was thinking about how we are with animals generally and whether we've become too corporate, you know, as people. And maybe that's just nature generally speaking and not just necessarily.
How do you mean? Say a bit more. But
I mean, sometimes I think we get the houses, you know, we get the high paid jobs and we understand the material, you know, the cars and stuff like that. But, you know, in terms of animals, certain animals give you a certain love, a kind of love and a different type of intimacy, you know, like nature gives you a different type of intimacy.
Yeah.
I think we can do the corporate side, you know, the business side. The beers and the whatever market, and we can do all of that. And the business entrepreneurs and everything, but are we still connected with nature in the ways that we should?
I think we're still struggling to connect with each other intimately.
Yeah, all that.
It does call to question when a human is more able to connect with an animal than they are with another human.
It's a
good point. True.
And you know, with, because this thing kind of connects to how we do our business, because one of the reasons why people want to use the US dollar or use English pounds, because they trust it. They don't trust their own money from their own country, and that just erodes trust, and then lack of trust erodes trust. So, you know, it has far-reaching consequences. So, we know that we're going to end now. If we can end on a positive, one thing that I can say is that we know that we do need intimacy, you know, and we should not deprive ourselves of it. Give me 1 second. I'm going to deal this dog. That's God knows. What's the matter with it? That's it. You're dead. You're dead. Remember, you're not paying the rent in here, you know. I'm from man, you need to take up a book. From man, you need to take up a book.
Pure play.
I was saying, Kush, you should have got to get one hamster instead, isn't it?
I don't know what I'm doing tonight, man. You know, so the show I go on, you just show off.
Well,
just love get attention, man. It's all right, man. You even know, so me, I listen to a show about some people. Is the Antarctic them go? One of them places there. And you know, them survive, don't they? They end up after you eat them dogs, so you can't steal them.
Thank goodness we didn't get any snow this year.
It takes a man easy. You see, man, I predict some 4 months shutdown and go on, no electricity, you can't leave your yard.
Oh,
hey.
Stop.
You see, man, don't start, you know. Don't start.
Get a cold tender meal out.
Yeah, isn't it?
The consequences
you need
like
little
much
jerk seasoning, isn't it? Jerk seasoning,
stop
man.
It. Not coming to yours for dinner, that's for sure.
So yeah, so ending on a positive, you know, let's just acknowledge that we need it, man. We need it, you know. Our farms are
absolutely
intimacy, you know? And that need, it's not going to change.
Yeah, we've never needed it more, I would say.
Absolutely. Conversation breeds intimacy.
Yeah, definitely.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, man, and one of the things I would say though is thank people. No, don't wait and put it off till the next time. Especially people who have contributed to your upbringing when you were young.
Yeah,
you know, just send them a message or whatever. Just thank them. You know, them kind of intimacy, communal intimacy, is very stress break. It lowers our stress levels. You know,
yeah,
it really has a direct impact. So. Thank people and thank them now.
Yeah, and I think, you know, I think it's very easy to take things for granted, particularly when we see people all the time and they're with us all the time. We take it for granted, you know, almost have an expectation that they're going to be there all the time.
Yes,
not true.
Very true. We have to learn to say it. Yeah, we have to learn to say it, because people don't necessarily know, do they? So maybe we need to just say it.
Yeah, man, it makes a difference.
Yeah.
So yes, so thank you for lending your mental forces to today's topic. Until the next time, walk good.
Peace and love and light.
Be blessed, family.
Take care, family. Take care, listeners.
ORT is a Glover Media production.
Included below are related links to this discussion. Please share, comment, and subscribe. And remember, talk the thing.